Hello guys, Arindam here with another video. So today I'll talk about a step-by-step guide on the entire process of planning and traveling to FIFA World Cup in 2022. Okay, so I have been getting queries regarding this. So how to get the visa, how to start, like how to budget and everything. So honestly, I have put out content out there in YouTube and on my website regarding these topics, but maybe some people are not really sure on what are the like exact steps on like how to start from the very beginning, right? It's not just about the buying the ticket, but the other miscellaneous processes that are involved in it. So I thought I would make this video. So without wasting any more time, let's jump onto the topic. So I have jotted down this 7 points. So your trip can be basically summarized in this 7 basic points, in my opinion. See, this is just my opinion. You can do it differently, you can have different opinions. That is, it's your free will, right? This is just a guideline or a kind of template that has worked for me in Russia, and hopefully it will work in Qatar as well. So firstly, the first step is basically you have to get a passport. See, if you are not from Qatar, then definitely you need to get a passport to travel to Qatar, right? So that is the very first step. If you don't have it right now, now is the best time in my opinion to get it. Please don't wait for it till the last moment, because if you are getting the passport for the first time, it involves police verifications and other things which may delay your process. And if you don't get your passport in time, just forget about traveling to FIFA World Cup, right? So I'm sure there are many videos available in the in YouTube or other websites which give you guide on how to apply for passport. It's very easy these days. You can apply online, or you can apply through a mobile app on your phone, right? So for that you will need like supporting documents like the Aadhaar card, address proof, and your age proof, right? So you need these kind of supporting documents. Your and photograph will be taken at the office, so you don't need to worry about that. Just check it out how it's done. If I don't get a suitable video or a suitable resource in the website, I'll make one myself. Don't worry about that, or else you can search the YouTube for that. So that is so once that is off the table, the next thing you need to do is make a budget. So budget will include your match ticket, your transport cost, your accommodation, your food, and etc. So firstly, I would suggest to budget your match tickets. So first decide which are the matches that you want to see, right? So that is very important. So once you have done that, then you will know how much it is going to cost. So I have made a video regarding this, so please go to my channel, it's Football Travelers, and there is a playlist called FIFA World Cup Qatar 2022 Essentials. So you will find all sort of informative videos that could help you in planning your FIFA World Cup trip. But for the match ticket video, this is the one that I'm talking about. So I had actually made an Excel, so that gives you a very good idea on how you can what could be your total budget of your ticket. So if you have budgeted for, if you want to see the finals and the semi-finals and stuffs and matches like that, then the cost would be different, and also it will differ on the categories of the seats that you apply for. So it doesn't mean that so you need to be a little flexible here, in my opinion. You cannot be rigid in terms of what matches you want to watch and which category you want to buy the tickets, but it will give you an overall idea. So for Russia, our total budget for the tickets were initially 60,000. We had planned to watch in the third category, that is the lowest category, 2 semi-finals and 1 final, but it did not happen. And we ended up watching, as you may already know, 2 group matches, 1 quarter final and 1 pre-quarter final in the second category, which was the price of which was quite expensive from the third category tickets, right? But since we watched group matches and pre-quarterfinals and quarterfinals, the prices were little lower than semifinals and finals. So our entire tickets had costed us around 52,000 to 53,000. I don't remember exactly. I have documented in my videos and the website. You can check that out. Okay. So once that is off the table, the next thing is that you have to travel for your transport and like accommodation, food and everything. So you need to make a budget for that. So for that, I would recommend you to refer to this article that I had written about 2 years back. So this is an article where I had given you a breakdown of like day to day and penny by penny breakdown of how much it could cost, your trip could cost, right? So this is a summary of in the end, I've put in a summary. So the actual expenditure that happened in Russia for me and the predicted expenditure in Qatar. So in this particular article, I had budgeted for 8-day trip to Russia, to Qatar. And see, you can see the accommodation is 9,600. So it is probably I had accounted for around 1,200 each day per person. So you just go through this article and have a look at this. It will give you an idea. So if it is for food, 8 days, I have accounted for 6,500, 400. So you can divide it by. So I have in this article, I have mentioned for each day how much it is going to cost for each person. So if your trip is going to be more than 8 days or less than 8 days, you can, adjust accordingly. And then few of the costs would be fixed, like for example, the flight cost. The flights are cheaper to Qatar than it was to Russia. So we spent 26,000 to go to Moscow from Delhi. But in my opinion, at least what the current prices are, and at least at the time when I wrote the article, the prices were quite cheap. It's going to change probably because the pandemic situation has made everything uncertain. I do not know. It could be less. It could be more. It all depends, right? So you need to account for the flight cost. Just do a research. I would probably make a video on how to research and buy the flight tickets in a cheaper price. I would probably do that, but if not, there are many videos in websites, many videos in YouTube and other websites that would help you in finding out what the cost could be, right? So once that is done, your food, travel and all these costs are there. You have a total budget. Please account for travel insurance, and I usually like adding like 15% contingency, because trust me, there would be things that will go wrong, and you want to be sure that you have a safety net or a buffer money so that you don't end up like in a very tight or difficult situation while you are on the trip. Okay, I wrote the article 2 years back, so at that point I had adjusted the inflation with 2%, so it was for 3.5 years at that point. So it is going to change, but overall, in my opinion, this is a decent amount to watch a certain number of matches, like 3 to 4 matches, depends on what matches you want to watch, whether it's the group league matches or it's the final matches and which are the categories. But this is a good amount, in my opinion, that could give you a World Cup experience. And I had also made a video on a very tight budget if you want to go there. So it was a video where I had talked about whether you can complete your trip within 50,000 rupees. So I would put a link to that video as well in the description. I don't see it in this playlist. Maybe I forgot to add that. But that is a very interesting video, in my opinion. You could play around with the budget I have put in there, and you can suppose if you want to just watch one match, so that could be ideal for you. Okay, the next point is start saving money. In my opinion, at this point of time, the best way to save money is put away money in a recurring deposit. If it was like 3 to 4 years till the World Cup, I would say you could put in some high return providing mutual funds or something, but now the markets are really uncertain and we don't know what's going to happen in the future, in the near future or in midterm future. So the best thing is to go for recurring deposit. So you can so once we have the total budget, you divide it by the number of months that are left till the World Cup, and of course you will need probably half of the money or a certain amount of the money for buying the tickets. So you need that money before at least around 9 to 11 months before the actual World Cup starts. So do your recurring that way. You could do like two recurrings or one recurring, and you could withdraw half of it and then do the rest of it. You could like play around with that as you wish. Okay, once you have done that, you have certain amount of money in your bank, and right, so when the tickets will go on sale, approximately about 9 to 11 months before the tournament starts, you have to buy the tickets, you have to apply for the tickets, you have to buy the tickets. So so all this I have explained in the video, how to buy a match ticket. You can go there and watch this. I have an article on this website also, you can watch you can read that as well. It's a similar information but just in a written form. Whichever suits you can do that. And once you have done with that, you have your tickets, you at least you have purchased your tickets, but you at this point you do not need it in your hand, but because it takes some time, right, it takes about a month to come to your home or whichever address you have provided. And the next step would be to apply for a visa or a fan ID depending on the situation. So in my opinion, I think Qatar might have fan ID this year, because in Russia it has worked so well, and Qatar may follow their footsteps. But if not, then you have to apply for a visa depending on from which country you are, right? So many countries have a visa free entry to Qatar for 30 days or 90 days, it depends on that. But if your country doesn't allow visa free entry or on arrival visa, you would have need to apply for a visa. But in most cases, I have looked up in the internet and seen in the past that you do not have to pay for the visa, like it was the case in Brazil. But the thing is that you had to go through the process of visa application, but the cost of the visa was waived off since you had bought a FIFA World Cup ticket. So that could be the case, or if it's a fan ID, then you don't have to worry about that. So when the tickets will go for sale, all this information will be out there, and also I'll keep updating you guys with that. At the moment, you do not need to worry about that. I have made detailed video on what a fan ID is and what are the advantages and disadvantages of having a fan ID. So you can go and check that. It is in the same playlist. The video title is All You Need to Know About Fan ID for FIFA World Cup. So you could have a look at that. It will give you an idea of what the fan ID is and how to get it and stuffs. And also I have made a follow along video on how to apply for a fan ID, but it was for Euro Cup to 2020 that was supposed to happen this year. But Russia was one of the 12 host countries, and for Russia they have fan ID this year as well, which is the Euro Cup is probably going to happen next year, but they had a fan ID for the matches happening in St. Petersburg, Russia. So you can have a look at that, you will know how to apply for a fan ID. So once that is done, you need to, okay, so I missed a point over here. I think the next step would be to buy flight tickets. Okay, so the next step would be to buy the flight tickets, in my opinion, because that is one of the most important thing once you have your actual match tickets. So like I said, I could make a video on how to book cheap flight tickets, how to look for cheap tickets. I could do that, and there are videos available as well. You could refer to those. So because you need to be in the country, right? So that is very important if you want to see the matches. So this is very important. And accommodation, always, if you have not yet booked it from the country, you could always go there and find something. That is not like earth shattering thing if you don't have booked, if you have not booked your accommodation. But in my opinion, that comes next in the priority, the booking the accommodation after the flights are booked. So you can use websites like booking.com. If you are a budget traveler like me, you can explore hostel worlds. Actually, booking.com also has many hostels listed in it, and you can find out which are the good places to stay. You can look at the reviews, and probably I'll make a video on that as well, how to do that. And once you have done that, you are almost ready to go, right? You have your match tickets, you have your fan ID or visa, whatever it is, you have your flight tickets, your accommodation is booked, and the next step would be to travel to Qatar. You just board your plane from where you have your tickets. You go there, go to the airport. There's nothing to explain in that. So, and then you go to the country and enjoy the FIFA World Cup. So I hope this was helpful, and if you have any queries, please, like always, leave it in the comments below. And if you have any questions and suggestions and anything I could improve this content, please let me know. All kind of constructive criticisms are welcome. See, I'm also learning like you guys are doing, so I'm just trying to share a little bit of my experience that I had in Russia and what has worked for me. And that being said, take care. See you in the next one. If you like this content, please like, put a like, hit the like button, and also don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.